वेलकम बैक टू द सेगमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्री व्यू एंड टुडे इज गोइंग टू बी इंटरेस्टिंग क्योंकि आज हम बात करने वाले हैं अबाउट एन इंडस्ट्री विच इज डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू एसेंशियल गुड्स एंड दैट इज डेयरी एंड पोल्ट्री विच इज अ पार्ट ऑफ आर डेली लाइफ राइट एंड सो वी आर गोना टॉक टू रौनक चंदक ही इज द को ओनर ऑफ पाम फार्म्स एंड ऑर्गेनिक डेयरी एंड वो हमें बताने वाले हैं कि वॉट हैज बीन द इम्पैक्ट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेक्टर बिकॉज ऑफ द लॉकडाउन.
Ronak, hi, welcome to this segment called Industry View. Thanks for being a part of this and giving us some time. So I'll quickly get to my first question. Of course, like the industry from where you come from, it's dairy and poultry, which is actually falling in the essential goods in our lives and which has been pretty much smooth running in a way, if we say. Even after the outbreak, even during the lockdown, everyone needs it and it has been available for everyone. But how has it been for you at the production end, at the distribution end?
Yeah, so Shubhro, thank you for putting me on this. Yes, they are essential services. So we have a poultry farm, we produce 50,000 eggs per day. And I'll break it down into very simple pointers, which will help your viewers to understand our perspective as a, in poultry language, we call us as farmers. So our segment. So, West Bengal, I'm placed in West Bengal. So West Bengal is one of the highest consumer of eggs. So it consumes around 2.5 crore eggs per day.
Wow.
And the fun part is that 70% of that figure comes from Andhra Pradesh.
Okay.
So, yeah, it is not produced in Bengal. It comes, 70% of that figure comes from Andhra Pradesh. So, Andhra Pradesh, in a big way, the dynamics of Andhra Pradesh market also affects the West Bengal market as far as eggs are concerned. Right. So now to go with the, current situation of, due to Corona, the shutdowns and everything. So the first, feedback, or you can say the first shocker came because all the schools and colleges and restaurants, all the institutional sales that we call was closed. And midday meals, which is a big, part where government plays a big role in supplying eggs for the midday meal. So that was also closed due to, social distancing norms and such things.
And the lockdown, yes.
Yes. So that brought a very big dip in the demand for the eggs. So, and at that time, you had Andhra Pradesh egg flowing in West Bengal at a very cheaper rate because their farms are bigger and they have to sustain. So, wo log kuch bhi rate mein, they are pushing the material in West Bengal.
So they had to let off their stock and and it got kind of piled up at your end.
Yes. So it piled up to an extent where, the X farm rate had gone to 2.5 rupees an egg. Okay. Right. And still there was no buyer. And
I'm sorry for interrupting. This brings a question in my mind that, of course, like since essential services and goods were allowed on roads and people who were distributing had the permission to be like on the roads and not to be harassed. But in your case, did you face any problem throughout the lockdown when, the product had to be kind of brought in from Andhra Pradesh and even when it was in the state of West Bengal while you had to kind of distribute it around? So have you been facing some kind of a problem from the operation end, manpower end?
So manpower end at our farm where we are making our, we are producing eggs was not a problem since most of the labor were in-house. So, everybody knew their travel history. So inside the farm, it was not a problem. Production of eggs was not a problem. Logistics was a big problem. And market middlemen were a very big problem. And yes, I would say the government played its part in keeping it, very smooth for the, transportation and everything. But still, for the first 7-10 days, everything, nobody knew what to do. So, and it was not clear also. And one more thing I would give credit to the government they did is that some of the farms, they were approved of some subsidies, which they fast-tracked. They fast-tracked the subsidies and made sure that the amount went to the farmers so that at least somewhere they, find something to stay alive. But that was only for approved projects. So, this was the state for the poultry, yeah.
And so that was the poultry bit. What about dairy, like milk? And you know, that's also, I think, I mean, we have a lot of vegetarians. I mean, keeping aside the people who consume egg, there's milk is also a like highly essential product. So how is that market for that, like?
So see, the biggest challenge in milk anyways is to follow the cold chain, right? From, you know, collection of milk to when I'm delivering it to your house, maybe. So the cold chain has to be followed. So that as a logistic is already a challenge in that business. But right. Yes, during this, you know, lockdown, collection of milk, you know, at milk centers, getting it to the packaging unit, and then, you know, distribution, all the logistic points were hit in the beginning. Because again, you know, everything is done by people. It's right. So if a person is not willing to drive a vehicle for you, you cannot force him to, you know, do it. So those sort of things, and that you know, were initial problems. But yes, I would give you, you know, parallels, because thankfully I have two aspects to give you. One is I had a brand of my own, and now we have done a tie up with Amul. Okay. So we'll be packaging 1 lakh liters for Amul in the coming months. So now I can give you a perspective of a local brand and a big brand. So for a local brand, this time was hugely challenging, because as it is, this dairy segment was going through a huge challenge because of increased price of milk, raw milk, and skim milk powders not available or available at very high prices. So you must have also seen, it was the first time in history of milk industry that price changes were made in a span of 6 months, and to right. the tune of 4 to 5 rupees a liter.
Yes,
so as a consumer, you must have also. Yeah, yes. You must have also noticed it. So the industry was already in turmoil, and then this pressure. So for a local player, it becomes literally difficult to get the, you know, supply chains coming and delivering the milk on time and supplying. And secondly, again, the institutional sales, you know, hotels and restaurants, and most big thing in West Bengal, at least, is the chai wala segment. So the chai consumption is a very big consumption as far as numbers are concerned for the dairy industry. And mostly, you know, big brands like Amul, Mother Dairy, they'll be in house tables, they'll be in household. But correct. For a local brand, the, you know, the sales are more in the institutional level, in the chai segment, you know, where you don't see the milk with which the chai wala is making the chai. You only love the tea.
Well, Ronak, thank you so much for that quick chat. And it's great to know about this industry also. We all survive on basic, your milk, eggs. These are very essential things of our lives. And it was very important for us to know what is going on in this particular market. Thanks for all that insight.